Audi came to the U.S. in 1969, and it took them 40 years to get to 100,000 units in sales. Last year, over 200,000. A big reason is the Audi A4. It's now in its ninth generation, and we're here at the launch of the 2017 A4. A lot of great changes and great driving dynamics. This car is a technological marvel and is sure to put the segment on notice. So we've had a full day. We started at 9 o'clock, had 2 hours of breakout sessions to learn all about the technology, the performance, the enhancements that have been made to this ninth generation A4, and they are significant. So from an interior standpoint, an all new interior, this car is an inch wider and you definitely feel it as being more spacious. You now have Apple CarPlay, you have two USB ports. Doesn't sound like a big deal to you, but to Audi it is. They've never had that in an A4 before. And of course, we have the virtual cockpit, which is available in the Premium Plus and the Prestige package, which between those two trim levels should account for about 75% of sales. So a lot of people are going to get this virtual cockpit, and it is nothing short of brilliant. It really takes technology to a new level. When you get into a 3 Series, it just feels dated compared to this vehicle, which has all this technology. You have 12.3 inches of high definition TFT LCD display in the virtual cockpit, plus another 8.3 inch in the upgraded screen versus 7 inches for the standard screen. So when you get the Premium Plus or Prestige packages, you're going to get almost 21 inches of high definition display. You also have a high definition display for the HVAC controls. You have dual climate control, standard, and you have these capacitive touch buttons for all your controls. So all of this has been completely redone and reworked. When you consider an entry level price point of $37,000, this car feels downright luxurious. And this is really the stepping stone for most buyers to get into the Audi brand, which is really kicking butt right now. From a design standpoint, Audi really went the extra mile. You have all new lighting up front as expected. So no more incandescent lighting. You have bi-xenon standard and LEDs as optional. Moving around here, one of the things we really liked that Audi did is, see this line, this is actually the hood line, and it's extended all the way throughout the vehicle. Notice this is the S line. That used to be an option on the upper trim levels, now standard on the Prestige. And moving back here, speaking of lighting, you also have LED taillights. Now, I want you to take a step back and take a look at this. Notice the height from the bottom to about two-thirds of the way up the greenhouse. That's two-thirds, this is one-third. That's designed to give it a sportier look. If you go back and look at vehicles, this is going really far back, Volvo Bertone, that one had like a really small greenhouse, and that's what this does. It's designed to give it a more sporty, more upscale feel, and I think it really works with the A4. One of the biggest improvements with the ninth generation A4 is a redesigned 2-liter turbo 4-cylinder engine, which now produces 252 horsepower. That's a significant upgrade of about 32 horsepower from the outgoing model. Also more torque, and it's all available under 2,000 RPMs, so very instantaneous power. Audi's done a great job mating this to their 7-speed dual clutch transmission. Everything just works seamlessly, whether in front wheel or quattro version. So Audi purposely put us on very challenging roads so we can experience the drive mode select as well as the new suspension. They also have, which is available on the upper trim levels, an adaptive suspension that continuously changes. It's not magnetic ride control, but it does continuously adapt to the driving conditions. And with all that, they still managed to shave a few pounds off this new suspension. It's a new 5-link axle suspension on the front and the rear, and that may not mean a lot to you, but even though we didn't drive the old model today, we could tell that this is a great handling car. If you buy one of these, take it out. Have some fun with it. Take it on some challenging roads. Don't just drive it on the freeway. That's what these vehicles are made for. Speaking of safety, there's a host of safety features, really too much to mention, but one that we really are excited about is the turn assist. Essentially, if you're going 7 miles an hour or less and you're about to make a turn, you're distracted for whatever reason, and there's a car coming from the other side that's about to nail you, you will be abruptly stopped. This is very impressive technology, as well as a host of other features. They even have something called Traffic Jam Assist. Overall, the seats have been redesigned and they're very comfortable. The suspension is completely new. It's lighter, it's newer. The car itself is lighter, 99 pounds for the front wheel drive and 66 pounds for the Quattro all wheel drive. It doesn't sound like a lot, but when you consider how much more technology they've added, that the car got an inch longer and an inch wider, but yet they reduced the weight, that is impressive. Also new, for the first time, the A4 gets an electronic shifter. So no longer you have a mechanical shifter, you now have an electronic one, which takes up less space. Audi really put a lot of effort into redesigning this A4. They tested it in six different countries, from New Zealand to the Italian Alps, which has, well, which has horrible roads, US, Nürburgring, everywhere. And they really, really believe in this product. And I believe in this product. I think with a $37,300 starting point, it makes a strong case. You have four Audi Drive Select options: comfort, auto, dynamic, and individual. Right now, we're gonna go into dynamic, which is the most aggressive or the sportiest mode. And everything from throttle response, suspension, and shift points, steering, are adapted immediately based on that, and you can feel it. You can feel at the higher speeds that the steering is a little bit different, a little tighter. And again, that's by design. This is meant to be a driver's car. Everything in this class is pretty good, but right now, because this is the latest and greatest, and I think because of the Quattro system and the upgraded engine, all the changes they've made, this is easily in the top one or two on that list. And it's a long list: 3 Series, C-Class, Lexus IS, the new Q50. We like the new Q50S. I'd still buy this over the Q50S. So there you have it, our review of the 2017 Audi A4. They're going to be launching with 3 trim levels: Premium, Premium Plus, and Prestige. They're available in front-wheel drive or Audi's all-wheel drive system known as Quattro. Base starting price will be $37,300. I'm Ron Doran. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on The Driver's Seat.